हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ इंडियाज़ फॉरेन पॉलिसी, वेयर आई विल कवर्ड रिमेनिंग पॉइंट्स ऑफ अवर पॉलिटिकल साइंस सेकेंड चैप्टर इंडियाज़ फॉरेन पॉलिसी इन फ्यू मिनट्स. बिफोर स्टार्ट दिस वीडियो आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू, इफ यू हैवंट सीन द फर्स्ट पार्ट, वॉच इट फर्स्ट. द लिंक ऑफ द फर्स्ट पार्ट इज गिवन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. आई सजेस्ट यू वॉच द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ इंडियाज़ फॉरेन पॉलिसी. So it will be easy to you to understand this part. Now let's start our today's video. After the taking primary information about foreign policy in the first part, we shall now get to know more about India's foreign policy. So let's start our today's video with our first point, that is India's foreign policy. Look at the slide. India's foreign policy. India got independence in 1947, and from then onwards we started shaping our foreign policy independently. The directive principle of state policy have laid down guidelines about how to shape foreign policy. Article 51 among the directive principle of state policy laid down the broad framework for foreign policy. According to it, India should give priority to safeguard international peace and security and resolve our international problem and dispute by peaceful means. The objective of our foreign policy should be to maintain friendly relation with other nations and respect international laws. India's foreign policy till now has been developed in this framework. Moving to the next slide, our next point is objective of India's foreign policy. They are as follows. The first objective is, while maintaining friendly relations with neighboring countries, ensure that the defense and security of India is not affected, not to compromise about the geographical boundaries of the nation. The second objective of India's foreign policy is, protect the unity and integrity of the country. Third objective is protect an interest of India's citizen living in other countries. This responsibility is fulfilled by the India's embassies there. And the last objective of India's foreign policy is to establish economic and commercial relations with other countries for achieving economic development of India. Next, I would like to introduce some information about a review of India's foreign policy. Our next point is a review of India's foreign policy. We shall take a review of India's foreign policy in two stages. The period from the independence to 1990 can be considered as the first stage, and the second stage would be from 1990 till date. First, we will take information about early phase. Look at the slide. India's foreign policy early phase. Prime Minister Pandit Nehru shaped India's foreign policy in the early period. He opposed colonialism through the India's foreign policy. He took an internationalist position and gave priority to global peace and security. Three things influenced India's foreign policy in this period. Among these three things, first one is, we made an effort to understand all international events and developments independently, without any pressures from any power. Peace has always been the central feature of India's foreign policy. The second thing is, the threat from China and Pakistan were also taken into the account. And the last one is, one more feature of India's foreign policy at this time was the insistence of the self-reliance. In the beginning, India decided to improve relations with the countries in Asia. Efforts were taken to cooperate with the Asian countries in order to achieve development and to keep our independence intact. This concept of regional development later expanded to include Africa as well. But some Asian African countries participated in the military pact led either by America or the Soviet Union. This stopped the process of regional development. After this, countries of Asia and Africa, which did not participate in this military pact, supported the concept of non-alignment. Peace and freedom become the fundamental principle of non-aligned policy. In this period, India had to fight conflict with the neighboring countries. Wars happened between India and Pakistan over the Kashmir questions in 1947 to 48 and 1965. In the Third War, that happened in 1971, Pakistan broke apart and independent Bangladesh was created. In the decade of 1970s, there came about some stability in India's foreign policy. India had risen as a powerful regional power in South Asia. By conducting nuclear tests in 1974, India had also proved her nuclear capability. From 1980, however, some changes began to take place. In order to increase cooperation among South Asian countries, South Asian Association of Regional Cooperation, that is SARC, was established. India initiated a dialogue to improve relations with China. India also started interaction with America for cooperation in the field of security. As we move on, our next point is first stage of India's foreign policy, that is from 1947 to 1990. Look at the slide, first stage of India's foreign policy. India adopted the policy of non-alignment in the context of the Cold War. As a result, priority was given to maintaining friendly relations with all nations and to taking the help required for development from different countries. Due to the policy of non-alignment, India could get aid from both the superpowers. There was a lot of stress on improving, strengthening India's defense. The technology required for this was important. Soviet Union, France and Germany helped India in this matter. In this period, India had to face some challenges. These included the conflict with Pakistan, creation of Bangladesh and conflict with China. India proved her nuclear capability by conducting nuclear tests in 1974. Our next point is second stage of India's foreign policy, that is from 1991 to the till date. Look at the slide, second stage of India's foreign policy. India's foreign policy became more comprehensive and dynamic in the second stage. In the post-Cold War period, the priority no longer remained to a political and military relations. Several other dimensions like economy, trade, education, and technology got included in the foreign policy. After 1991, India reduced the government controls over the economy and adopted the free market policy. Naturally, there was an increase in trade with a neighboring countries. Our share in world trade increased. Efforts began to made to increase the rate of economic growth. In the decade after 1990, our relation with South Asian countries like Singapore, Thailand, Vietnam, etc. became stronger. Our trade exchange with Israel, Japan, China and European Union increased. India began to participate in organization at the international and regional levels more than before. For example, G20 and BRICS, that is Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. Our relation with America strengthened. Mutual trust grew. India's state rose in the international community. And now the last point of our this chapter is nuclear policy. Look at the slide, India's nuclear policy. India's nuclear policy is an important part of India's foreign policy. You must have studied the meaning of nuclear energy and its uses in subjects like history, geography, and chemistry. Having understood the importance of nuclear power, India undertook the nuclear energy program immediately after independence. For this, we established the Department of Atomic Energy and the Indian Atomic Energy Commission. The first chairman of the Indian Atomic Energy Commission was Dr. Homi Bhabha. Even though electricity generation was the main purpose behind the program, it also aimed at a certain military capacity. As a consequence of this, India conducted her first nuclear test in 1974. India built a nuclear weapons and conduct nuclear test in 1998. We have also made missiles carrying nuclear weapons, and the Air Force and a Navy have been unable for carrying them. India is now a country which has nuclear weapons. We have accepted the role of a responsible nuclear power. India has been constantly supporting efforts for a disarmament because it is India's position that there should be peace and security in the world. In this way, we have finished our chapter. Having taken a survey of foreign policy in this way, we are going to study India's defense system in the next chapter. I hope you understand the lesson. I would like to end my video by saying that if you have any doubt, any query, any problem related to this chapter, you can ask in comment section. See you in the next video. Thank you. Thanks for listening.